In the last video, we looked at basic notation for scalars, vectors and tensors. In this video, we will look at some very basic operations that we can do on scalars, vectors and tensors. You should be familiar with most of this already. There are a couple of special operators that we will be looking at, but most of you are familiar with this even from high school. So, the operations that we will be covering in this video are addition and a special type of addition called broadcasting. Then we will be looking at multiplication. Within this, you will look at the matrix product, the dot product and something called the Hadamard product. All it is an element wise multiplication. Finally, matrix transpose and the inverse. Okay. So, I would suggest that you can skip this video if you already know this. This is very basic material. So, addition, as you know, a normal matrix addition is simply you take one matrix and you add the other matrix to it element wise. Okay. For this, of course, the sizes need to match. So, if A is m cross n, B also has to be m cross n and C also has to be m cross n. An example is shown on your screen. This is basically MATLAB output. So, you take some simple matrix A, in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, add another matrix B and it gives you the output C. You can see any element. If you see the element in C which is 12, this is simply the corresponding element in A added to the corresponding element in B. Now, a special type of addition which we will be using within machine learning, this is usually a programmatic thing rather than, you know, really mathematical, but in a program we often add a matrix. This is actually just a vector. And this gives back a matrix. So, let us say you have an m cross n matrix and C also has to be m cross n. What you do in this case is, in case either the number of rows or all the number of columns of B matches, you tend to make multiple copies of the same vector and add it. Okay. This is called broadcasting. It's adding a vector to a matrix by simply repeating the vector so that it comes to the same size as the original matrix. Obviously, it can be done only if the vector that we are choosing either has the same number of rows or the same number of columns. Okay. This is automatically done in MATLAB and NumPy, especially in the recent versions of MATLAB. NumPy is a Python library which we will be looking at in the third week. So, this is done automatically in both of these. Just to show you an example. Let us say A is the same old 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and B is the, well, in this case the row matrix 1, 1, 1. Okay. Then all you need to do is this 1, 1, 1 gets added to the first row, gives you 2, 3, 4. It also gets added to the second row which is 4, 5, 6 and gives you 5, 6, 7. Okay. So, this happens automatically within MATLAB. We did not have anything special written here. I just put A plus B. Similarly, in NumPy also this kind of addition is done automatically. It is assumed that if you have a size mismatch, then you actually have broadcasting going on. Multiplication. So, of course, all of us are familiar with the matrix product. So, this also needs a size match. You know that the first element of the product comes from a dot product essentially of the first row with the first column. Similarly, if I have the ijth element, this is the ith row and the jth column multiplied together give me the ij element. Mathematically, it can be written in this way, summation over k of aik bkj. Is equal to Cij. We know that as usual, if you have m cross n and n cross p, then C's size is m cross p. Okay. sizes of course must match, in the sense that you must have the number of the second element in this case match the first element in this case. So, the number of columns and the number of rows have to match. You can also have, as usual, a matrix multiplying a column vector. So, we have seen one such example here. You also have something called the Hadamard product. This is simply an element wise multiplication. All we have to do is to say that if A is m cross n and B is m cross n, then C is also m cross n. All you are saying is Cij is equal to Aij multiplied by Bij, no summation unlike here. You just take the corresponding element here, take one element here, multiply it and it gives you the corresponding element there. This is analogous to what we did with addition. Why is it that the normal matrix product is defined in this weird way? It turns out that it has several advantages linear algebra wise. We do not have the time to go through that in this course. But it turns out that more often than not, when products occur, they usually occur as matrix products rather than as Hadamard products. But nonetheless, in deep learning and in machine learning, we will encounter this kind of element wise multiplication multiple times, which is why that is being written out as a separate thing. So, just as an example is flashed on your screen here, we have taken the same old A, again the same B, and you have a corresponding multiplication. For example, the 2-2 element here is 5, 2-2 element in B is 7 and 2-2 element in C is 35. Finally, we have the vector product. We are not going to look at cross products really as far as this course is concerned. That comes more in physics. In machine learning, usually we are dealing with dot products. So, a dot product, you remember, is the product simply between two vectors which gives you a scalar. We know that this dot product simply is a1 b1 plus a2 b2, so on and so forth up till an bn. Of course, the assumption is a and b are of the same size. What is more important here is one example is given there. If A is 1, 2, 3 and B is 4, 5, 6, then alpha, the dot product, is 4 plus 10 plus 18, which gives you 32. Now, more importantly, as far as machine learning is concerned, we can usually also write it in this notation. This is what I would call matrix notation. This is vector notation. Since we will deal a lot with matrices, it is sometimes useful to see this as matrix notation. So, in this case, I can write it as A as, really speaking, vectors should always be represented as columns. So, you write one of these as a column vector and one of these as a row vector. This would be A transpose B. That also gives you the same product using the matrix product rules, 1 times 4 plus 2 times 5 plus 3 times 6. So, the dot product can be written as A transpose B. So, A dot B can be written as A transpose B. Of course, since alpha is a scalar, if you take transpose of this whole thing, you can also write this as B transpose A. So, if I had written it as 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, it would not have made a difference because I am still making the same product. So, we will be using this kind of notation repeatedly. So, if I do A transpose times B, transpose in MATLAB is represented by a prime. So, A prime here denotes A transpose. Obviously, that is going to give you the same result. So, this kind of thing we will be using extremely often. So, please get comfortable with this, which is denoting a dot product between two vectors as A transpose B or B transpose A and also as A dot B. So, all these three will be used interchangeably. I am going to write this again. A dot B, in case A and B are vectors, is the same as A transpose B, is the same as P transpose A. A couple of other operators that we will be looking at. First is of course the transpose. Transpose, all of you know, is simply written as A transpose. Mathematically, all you do is you take sort of across the diagonal, you take a mirror image in case it is a square matrix. So, Bij will be Aji. Okay. So, if you have the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the same matrix we have been using, it gets flipped. So, if A has size 2 cross 3, P becomes a 3 cross 2 matrix and the elements flip. Inverse is a matrix which gives you, when multiplied by the original matrix, it gives you back the identity. Whether you left multiply it or right multiply it, we are going to assume here that A is square. So, if A is of size n cross n, A inverse is also of size n cross n, and you, when you multiply A and A inverse, inverse is that matrix which when you multiply it by A, you are going to recover I. I is of course the identity matrix which has 1 in the diagonal and zeros everywhere else. I will just represent it as a big 0. Okay. So, this is I, you are going to get an n cross n I matrix. Okay. Now, it is important to know that not all square matrices have a good valid inverse. It is also possible to find out matrices, inverses in the case of non-square matrices. In such cases, we use something called the pseudo inverse, which we will be looking at later on in the course. So, just as an example of an inverse, if I take a random 3 by 3 matrix and take its inverse, if I multiply the matrix by its inverse, you recover the identity matrix. One thing I would like to point out is, you will notice that the zeros are not quite 0, you have some decimal places of accuracy. This is something very important, this is called finite precision, which means just like in your calculator, you have only certain number of digits that you can represent accurately. You know, depending on the calculator, you might have 8 or 10 places. Okay. And certain other digits are actually uncertain, you are not sure what happens after the 8th digit. In many cases, the result that the computer gives will actually be accurate only up till a certain number of digits, typically 16 number of digits, okay, if you have what is called double precision. We will be looking at the implications of this later on, but you can kind of see it that some of the off diagonal terms is calls positive and some of them it calls negative, because you know maybe the 10th or 11th digit is a 1 or a 2 or something of that sort. Okay. So, in this video, what we looked at are some basic simple operators. We looked at addition, more importantly broadcasting, which is an extension of addition. In C, you would do it using overloading the operator. We also saw element wise multiplication, and the other operators are some things that you should have been already familiar with. Thank you.